Alright, welcome back everybody to the YouTube channel BTCTV, and we continue to do videos about business, famous people in business and conferences all around the world. Right now we are in the Web Summit in Lisbon, and I'm happy to present our host is Viktor. Viktor is the founder of TeqBall, a new sport discipline. Viktor, thanks for coming to our TV show.
Thank you so much.
I was amazed how TeqBall moved so fast during a very short period of time. But maybe not so many knows what is TeqBall is all about. Can you please explain what is this sport is about?
The best way to explain is, of course, to watch the videos of Ronaldinho playing TeqBall. But it's a curved ping pong table where we play football on this table, and it just became a platform for competition on a compact space. You don't need that much space. There is no physical contact. So what we like in football is the skill of the players. So you get a lot of that in TeqBall because it's a very fast game. You have three touches maximum, and then the players can play single or double, and they have to return the ball to the other side. It must bounce once on the table, and they need to handle the ball and send it back. So that was the idea, and now it's catching up.
Okay, and when this idea came, and why you decided to join this one?
I think it was kind of a life demand, because we used to play football, and you know, life changed. Nowadays people don't have the same as we had like 1970s, 80s. People just stay back at home. Our friends, they all told us they can't make it to the five-a-side football. So we ended up always having like one or two or three guys who wanted to play football instead of having 12 guys. So we decided that it's just much better to do something what you can even do in your garden. And that was the idea, that you don't need that much space, you don't have that many people anymore, you know.
Yeah.
And then the other thing is that we wanted to play football still, and we use the same ball as football in TeqBall. So that's how we ended up having the table. And me and my two co-founders, we just love sports, we love football. So we started to play this game back home. We created the first tables, the prototypes, just for ourselves to play and experience the game. And then of course we invited some other friends who all loved it and who all started to ask questions, what is the name of this game and so on. And then more and more people told us that this is great, it's going to be huge.
Yeah, I am amazing how huge it is right now. Ronaldinho is one of your ambassador, different famous football clubs using your tables for practicing and playing, right? Our channel is a little bit more about business, right? But even sport is also kind of business, right? So in your opinion, what is must people, for example, if somebody wants to start some business in sport, what tips you will give to them for make it more successful?
So TeqBall is changing the way we look at international federations. Mm-hmm. So if you think about the Table Tennis Federation, what is the product of Table Tennis Federation? It's not the tables itself, they don't sell that. Also FIFA doesn't sell the balls. So we changed this a little bit. We said that everyone in the world of sport talks about how sport is non-profit, but at the same time
everyone talks about how sport is a business.
Right. So all these non-profit federations at the same time sell events for billions and sponsors and broadcasting and so on. So we just said that no, we believe that sport is a business,
right.
It's an industry, and we also want to make a sustainable international federation where the commercial profits can be returned, and we actually help those in need, like federations in less developed countries. We support them with the equipment, we support them with money to organize competitions. So we try to balance this through our model, and of course selling the tables and having all the patents and trademarks helps us a lot. I give you a very good example. Imagine you invented table tennis. So you are the only one in the world who deals with table tennis. So that's what happened to us. We invented TeqBall, we trademarked, patented it, and we are the only ones who make decision about this sport. It's a good feeling because it's ours. At the same time,
we keep it open because a lot of other
people have good ideas about this sport and the disciplines and what to do with the table. So that's how we set up now the structure. And I suggest for those who want to start sport businesses, they also look into this disruption direction. And this direction, like how can you change a bit the existing old-fashioned model? And if you have any good idea, then it's going to be very difficult, whoever is trying a sports startup, because it's not just about the influencers, you know, even if you have Ronaldinho and so on, it's not just about that. I think you need to have a very, very extended network in those decision-making bodies, which can help you to go through the first milestones. That was my experience with TeqBall.
Thanks. Now, let's talk a little bit about your relationship with Ronaldinho, because he's like your ambassador and you are dealing with him almost on daily basis. What can you say about him, like from business perspective, like a partner? How it is easy? Do you argue with him, for example? Do you maybe have fights? I don't know.
So I just made this joke with him yesterday that I see you more often than my wife. And it's a bit like that. So of course you sometimes have arguments with your wife, but it's rather because it's not, you know, we don't really have arguments. Mm. It's rather that we have such a tight schedule, and you know, he's a superstar.
Yeah.
So it can be frustrating. Even Web Summit can be frustrating, because going from one place to the other, everyone wants to take a photo. Yeah. And so on. Imagine you can't sit down to have a dinner. Mm-hmm. Because someone comes to you to take a photo all the time. And if you are nice, and you are nice, and Ronaldinho is super nice, mm-hmm. he does take the photo, but then the others want to take the photo, and so on. So that's a challenging situation in general to be a superstar. You know, he has, I don't know, like 80 or 100 million followers, and you know, we just saw the numbers that we are like 80 million interactions in the last couple of days. So that's the challenge for us. But on business side, it's quite you know, like managed with the team of Ronaldinho. So Ronaldinho is not involved in the daily business. He is involved, and of course we prepare for these appearances, and everything is with practice. So you know, it's natural, it's instinctive, but the framework is planned. So I suggest for everyone that, you know, it's not just it happens, mm-hmm. we actually plan it. I was here at like 7 a.m. in the morning, mm-hmm. to do the rehearsal. You know, it's main stage, 15,000 people, press conference, sports stage. You saw the crowds.
Yeah.
I'm quite confident we were the most successful.
Actually, yes. Actually, I agree with you that you've been more successful, that more journalists, more followers everywhere where you are coming.
Yeah, so you see that, and of course it's pressure. Mm-hmm. So it's pressure on my shoulder as well, but on Ronaldinho's shoulder is super huge pressure, because whatever he says, you know, that has a weight. Mm-hmm. He can't say just something like that out of the air. Press is there, people are there, they take photos, it's his image, his life. So it's a huge pressure we have to deal with, and of course that can be again sometimes challenging, but I'm not complaining. I think we have a wonderful family type of relation with the whole family of Ronaldinho, and we spend really a lot of time together, and I think that we learned how to deal with each other. In the beginning, as everyone, we had challenges because the culture is a bit different and so on, but now we I think have a very smooth way of living these events, and I'm doing 3 more events with him this year, so I'm going to spend you know, out of the 40 days that's ahead of me, around like 15 together with the team.
Okay, we spoke about what is TeqBall, about past, about present. Now let's talk about the future of TeqBall. Yesterday you mentioned already that maybe it will be one of the disciplines at Olympic Games. And if to look about some sports like basketball, American football during the last 100 years, how they came popular with big businesses right now, where do you see TeqBall is going to be in the next 100 years?
So I think that the consequence of what we do is that TeqBall can become an Olympic sport.
Okay.
So the young appeal, the youth appeal of the sport and all these followers we have and so on, this all leads to that TeqBall can be considered, because it actually brings benefit for the Olympic world. Even if you compare now, you know, weightlifting and, I don't know, wrestling and many, many sports, they are traditional sports, but the audiences are changing. So I think it's great to keep traditional sports, but breakdancing is not an Olympic sport in Paris. So you see the Olympic movement is opening for the youngsters, and TeqBall fits into that perfectly. And we also have those steps that are the legal steps that we are officially recognized by the Olympic Council of Asia, Africa, and so on. We are a competition sport at the next Asian Beach Games. So these are the steps which helps us, and then I think it can be considered maybe for the LA or the Olympics after that as an official sport. In terms of the business environment, I think that in the 100 years, TeqBall should be definitely a top 5 or top 10 sport. If you think about it, it's based on football, and football is far the biggest,
yes.
Far the biggest, in terms of numbers as well, far the biggest. Second, it's what the world is reflecting now, compact and fast. So that's what happened. We are speeding up with everything, and TeqBall is a reflection of that. And then the structure of the game itself, you know, that simply for broadcasting, for sponsors, you can put stuff on the tables. So everything is by accident commercially viable with the game, you know, that's what
the game
I see.
Is moving more faster, you see more faster points. For me, for example, I'm not a big fan of football, because for me it's a little bit boring to sit and watch like for 1 hour when you will see a goal. Here, you see, actually, more I'm thinking about TeqBall, more I love it. I mean, more I see benefits from it. More it's like, yeah, it makes sense.
Yeah, we used to say that, you know, the we solve the problems of football.
Yeah.
Because what I don't like in football is that there's no action.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sometimes it can be very boring,
yeah.
And so on. And then also that sometimes players, you know, fake dive and pretend, and you don't know whether was it an injury or not, and so on. And also the reason why we love football is those few moments,
yeah.
The dribbles and the goals. Mm-hmm. So we tried with TeqBall to package that into this game. Every 2-3 seconds you have some nice move, some skill move, some, you know, amazing solution with the ball, and then at the same time no one is going to dive and pretend that I was injured. There's no physical.
Yeah.
Imagine someone in TeqBall like, oh, you know, like, but that was no contact. So
yes.
So you see that the beauty of football is packaged into TeqBall.
I see. Viktor, thanks about that. Before we finish, how about maybe we'll make a small challenge with our subscribers that one video will be live, they will start asking interesting question, and in a couple of weeks you will select the best question. And the best question will be awarded, I don't know, maybe a signature from Ronaldinho or autograph from Ronaldinho.
Oh, we can do that quite easily. I'm asking my assistant, do we have a Ronaldinho signed shirt here? Okay,
wow.
let's do that. It originally we didn't know about that, but let's say that we have this Ronaldinho signed
wow.
jersey.
Wow.
So I'm very happy to offer this for
the best question.
Yeah, I think in terms of anything, feel free to use your imagination. The best questions get a TeqBall package, including a Ronaldinho
wow.
signed TeqBall Brazilian jersey.
Wow, that's
so
amazing. I can imagine. So start asking interesting questions below this video. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel BTCTV for such more great videos. And thanks again, Viktor.
Thank you.
Thank